Hello and welcome everyone. In this video, we will review another useful approach to solve boundary value problems that is based on a direct discretization of the differential equations. The idea is that we divide the interval AB into n subintervals, and the spacing between the two points or the width of an interval is represented by dx or h. Finite difference methods approximate derivatives of a function using values at discrete points. The stencil defines which points around the point of interest are used in the calculation. For example, a three-point stencil looks like this, whereas a two-point stencil might look like this. And if we want to approximate the first derivative with finite differences, an example of three-point stencil will be a central difference, whereas examples of two-point stencils are forward and backward differences. Let's see how we can determine the finite difference coefficients of a first-order derivative approximation given a three-point stencil, which is minus 1, 0, and 1. Again, we'll start by writing Taylor series for f about x. Since given stencil is minus 1, 0, 1, we want a derivative approximation which is equal to a f of x minus h plus b f of x plus c f of x plus h. And we need to determine the values of a, b, and c to generate the desired finite difference approximations. For that, we will replace the f of x minus h and f of x plus h by their corresponding Taylor series expansions. And since we have three coefficients, we'll keep the first three terms of the Taylor series expansion. With a little bit of manipulation and comparison of the coefficients between the left-hand side and the right-hand side, we can get these three equations. And we can solve this system of algebraic equations to find the values of a, b, and c. We can then place these values into above approximation to get the desired central difference approximation of the first derivative. We can use the same methodology to compute the approximation for any given stencil and derivative order. Let's now learn about how we can solve a boundary value problem using the finite difference method. The first step that we need to do is to discretize the equation on the grid. For that, we will divide the interval into n subintervals. In this case, let's assume we use 50 subintervals. Then, the width of the subinterval or spacing between two adjacent points on the grid is 0.04. Then, in the next step, we use the standard central difference formulas to approximate the derivatives. We then place these derivatives into our differential equations to get a discretized form at point xi. And we can also write our boundary conditions in discretized form. Now, we can use a method like Newton's method to solve this nonlinear system iteratively. Here we plot numerical solutions for both the shooting method that we discussed in the previous video and the finite difference method. For finite difference solution, in this case, we use n is equal to 50. The finite difference method is a powerful technique for solving ODEs and PDEs, and we will see in the coming videos how we can use these to solve complex problems. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my channel and see you in the next video.